More than 60,000 structures have been found underneath the Amazonian vegetation in the small country of Guatemala alone. All of them were identified by Lidar and seemed to be oriented to true north, just like many other civilizations around the world. In such a tiny country, with just 100,000 square kilometers in size, one can only imagine what is hidden in the 5.5 million square kilometers of the Amazon forest. Most people, when asked about the history of the Americas, are quick to name the three famous civilizations known for their architecture, art, engineering and culture. The Mayans were known for being the longest and more prosperous of the group and are often viewed as the greatest Mesoamerican civilization. The Incas are famous for being the shortest lived of the bunch, but at the same time the most advanced. The Aztecs, on the other hand, are remembered for their precise calendar, sophisticated hieroglyphs and, well, human sacrifices. Some history nerds might be also commenting right now about the Olmecs, an often forgotten civilization thought to be responsible for the invention of the writing in Mesoamerica and for passing on knowledge to the Mayans. And this video is exactly about that. The list represents civilizations in South and Central America. If you've watched my video about the Aztec Empire, you might remember me mentioning that the Aztecs themselves don't claim to have built most of their pyramids. In fact, much more ancient and mysterious civilizations such as the Totonacs, Nahuas and Otomis are all candidates for being the original builders of these massive structures. When the Aztecs arrived at the Anahuac Valley, near modern-day Mexico City, they found an abandoned site with magnificent pyramids and structures, evidence of an advanced civilization who came before them. The city had been destroyed 600 years prior to the Aztecs' arrival, so they named the place Teotihuacan, the City of Gods. Unfortunately, we don't know the original name of the city, or even the name they used for themselves. While there are some inscriptions in the city, they are pictographic, meaning they are just symbols, so there is no way to tell what language it was. But we do know now that it was the largest city in the pre-Columbian Americas, with a population estimated at 125,000 or more, making it at least the 6th largest city in the world during its time. Records show that apparently, the Teotihuacan civilization had commercial ties with the Mayas, with the latter using the glyph P to refer to the city, and this makes sense as the Mayans were spread over a vast area in the American continent and have been around since the 15th century BC. What doesn't make sense, and has been making archaeologists around the world scratch their heads, was what Brazilian farmers started to find deep inside the Amazon forest.
I had this guy, Graham Hancock, on, and he was talking to me about all the different shit they're finding in the Amazon and in South America, and that there used to be 20 million people that lived in the Amazon, and they died off because of sickness. They were visited mostly, like, apparently Europeans, when they came in like the 1500s, they would tell these incredible stories about these huge civilizations in the Amazon. But then when explorers came back 200 years later, there was nothing there. And they were like, this is crazy. They lied. They must have lied. But it turns out they didn't lie. What happened was smallpox ran through the jungle and killed everybody.
We did it.
And then the jungle just overtook these cities. And now they're finding these cities with something called Lidar. They use these planes and they circle over this area and they shoot Lidar. It's like laser radar, and it gives you a detailed image of what's below the surface and what's
there.
And it shows them all these crazy structures, all these like roadways and irrigation systems and circles inside of a square. Like, it was villages and cities, and millions of people probably lived there.
Fuck.
And all of it was swallowed up by the jungle. They think within like 100 years just vanished in the jungle because it's so lush and tropical down there.
As farming necessities pushed the Brazilian farmers to move further west into the Amazon forest, they began to notice these weird shapes and structures that were too peculiar to be of natural origins. So they called up archaeologists and historians who began recognizing these structures as being man-made. This was revolutionary. No one was expecting this level of development across South America, in lands known to be awful for farming. The latest research suggested that there could have been a total population in South America of 20 million people, with their biggest cities reaching sizes of 125,000 inhabitants. This might not seem that impressive, but to give you some context, London at the time had just over 60,000 people living in it, and Europe as a whole was only twice as large, with roughly 50 million people. So obviously, as the Brazilian farmers kept finding these structures beneath all the dense forests, they couldn't ignore it for much longer and started showing it to scientists and archaeologists, who could not believe their eyes. Archaeologists from all over the world started rushing into the Amazon, eager to be the first to find a new breakthrough in the mystery of the ancient South America. At first, progress was slow, as there was a lot of bureaucracy and pushback from companies trying to use land to make a profit, but these were actually not the biggest problems the scientists faced at the time. The problem was that tropical forests are insanely dense and difficult to explore. It's like as soon as you enter it, you can only see a radius of 3 meters around you and can easily get lost. Only in 2009, a brave couple of archaeologists decided to hire a small plane with a Lidar device on the bottom to try and scan the area they've been exploring by foot for months, to see if this new 3D laser scanner could be used to find anomalies in the jungle and help identify potential man-made structures, and boy it did. In a span of 9 hours of flight, the couple covered an area 10 to 100 times larger than what they previously had explored by foot, and were able to identify hundreds of new structures and worlds made by the ancient civilizations who once ruled the land. The couple even stated that they identified new structures in places they had already stepped foot a few years prior to this innovation, and some of the places were just 2 meters away from where they walked through. That just goes to show how good LiDAR scanners can be in spotting these findings in dense rainforests. But I'm leaving the impression that this is all new information, discovered in the last few decades, when in fact, that's not really the case. For centuries, the locals in these remote places reported that they were once part of a much larger civilization. However, they were ignored by the anthropologists of the time. It wasn't until recently in the 1990s, when new evidence came to light of a Spanish explorer who traveled there before the conquistadors, when scientists started accepting this theory. Francisco de Orellana was the first European explorer to explore the entire length of the Amazon River. He, together with 220 Spaniards and 4,000 natives, set out to explore deep into the jungle by following the Amazon River. The expedition started in 1541, where the men left what is now Ecuador and headed towards east, going down the river. On the way to east, where they would eventually get to the Atlantic Ocean, they reported encountering huge civilizations settled deep inside the jungle with massive pyramids, incredible arts and crafts, millions of people, a thriving culture, kilometers of roads and massive stone structures. Along the way, many of these empires proved to be really advanced and sometimes not welcoming, seeing that by the end of the expedition, only half of the Spaniards had survived. Francisco rushed to the Spanish royalty to tell the news about these many large settlements and cities that populated the region which today is impenetrable jungle, but Spanish and Portuguese royalty didn't pay much attention to his claims. Why, you may ask? Well, we got to travel back in time and realize what was happening in the Iberian Peninsula at the time. Portugal was busy trying to control the sea trading routes to the east and around Africa, while Spain, with the help of Columbus, had just found a new world to the west, and although both countries started sending expeditions to this part of the world, they had other internal and external conflicts to solve, so they weren't able to commit their full resources into these expeditions. Add to this the fact that the first explorers usually exaggerated about their findings in South and Central America to try and convince the Iberian kings to send more reinforcements to them, and we start to understand why it took some time for Europe to realize the potential of the new world. So 100 years after the reports were made public to the Europeans, the conquistadors arrived in South America to fight and conquer these apparently amazing civilizations, only to find that there was nothing but thick jungle in most cases. So it was ruled that the reports made by Francisco 100 years prior were nothing but a desperate attempt to attract funding for exploration and were largely dismissed as being untrue. But now we are starting to find out that maybe Francisco is owed an apology. Historians, now with his recent findings made by LIDAR and on-site archaeologists, realize that there were in fact huge civilizations in the Amazon before the 1500s. The most accepted theory is that the first explorers being in contact with these populations brought with them smallpox and other diseases, which decimated virtually everybody in the cities. As the population died out, with only the youngsters surviving, the knowledge was eventually all lost, with advanced empires now down to small tribes, and the vegetation took care of the rest, spreading over these sites and making them invisible to the naked eye. This theory was first presented in the 2005 book 1491, New Revelations of the Americas Before Columbus by Charles Mann, which describes how our picture of the indigenous American people was distorted by the toll that diseases took on them. In many cases, those who were left were children who had lost the elder generation that carried most of the culture's knowledge, so the explorers assumed they had always been primitive, ignorant, and uncivilized, not realizing that their cultures had been civilized and often quite sophisticated before European diseases erased all traits. In fact, still today there are untouched tribes deep inside the Amazon who attack anyone who tries to get near them and even shoot helicopters and drones who get too close to comfort. So it's not that hard to imagine that 500 years ago, huge civilizations were somewhere along one of the biggest forests in the world, just waiting to be found. The Aztec Empire has a pretty fascinating story of how it was discovered as well. If you'd like to know it, please watch my previous video about that breathtaking capital. Thanks for watching. Obrigado.